In the summer of 844 AD, the inhabitants of Seville woke up to a group of Vikings camped outside of its city. Seville, like most of the Iberian Peninsula at the time, was in the hands of the Emirate of Cordoba. So what happened when the Vikings went toe-to-toe with the Muslim rulers of Al-Andalus? Let's find out. This video is part of Vikings Month, a collaboration between various history YouTubers that focuses on the epic history of the Vikings. I'll leave a link to the playlist in the bio for you to watch the other videos on the Vikings as well. The 9th century was the height of the Viking Age, a period which saw many of the major cities of Northern and Western Europe raided by Scandinavian warriors launching themselves from their longboats. The objective? Looting mostly. Descending down from their homelands in Norway, Denmark, and Sweden, they targeted major cities that could be accessed by water. You would think this would restrict them to attacking coastal regions only, but as much as the Vikings have deservedly earned a reputation for being fearsome, they were also masters of seafaring, so they would often sail up the estuaries of major European rivers and raid cities that were inland. In addition to looting, the Vikings were also interested in acquiring wealth through legitimate means, because they were very capable traders. But this would be the focus of another video in a few weeks, which will speak about the Vikings and their relationship with the Abbasid Caliphate. The Umayyads of Al-Andalus, on the other hand, were in the process of formalizing the implementation of their royal authority on the realm. An offshoot of the Umayyad Caliphate that ruled the entirety of the Islamic world until 750 AD, the Umayyad Emirate of Cordoba was established by Abdulrahman I, who had survived the slaughter of his family by the Abbasids and made his way from Syria to Spain under constant threat from Abbasid assassins. Al-Andalus was a complicated political landscape complete with social tensions, regional divisions, not to mention the perennial threat of attack from the Christian kingdoms of northern Iberia. It was in the reign of Emir Abdulrahman II, reigning from 822 to 852, that the administration of Al-Andalus really started to take shape. I want you to remember this when we speak about the Umayyad response to the Viking raid on Seville. The Vikings who would go on to attack Seville in 844 had already targeted other regions in the Iberian Peninsula. Launching themselves from their base in western France, these Vikings had plundered parts of Asturias in northern Spain before either being driven off by the local ruler or choosing to move further down south. They continued their plundering of the Atlantic coast of Iberia until they encountered the city of Lisbon, the modern-day capital of Portugal, which they decided to raid and even held for a number of days before being driven off by the Umayyad governor of Lisbon. After that, they kept moving south along the Iberian coastline, raiding the important southern cities of Cadiz and Algeciras. Then they sought to sail up the Guadalquivir river and attack as many cities as they could find. If like me, you're a fan of etymology and understanding the origins of certain words or terms, then you'll be interested to know that the name Guadalquivir comes from the Arabic Wadi al-Kabir, meaning the Great Valley, because of the amazing fertility of the land around the Guadalquivir River. Back to the Vikings. They were in luck because the key city of Seville is located near the Guadalquivir. At the time, Seville did not have city walls. So towards the end of September in the year 844, the Vikings proceeded to looting and raiding the city. Emir Abdulrahman II reacted swiftly. He had already been informed by his governor in Lisbon about the Viking raid there. Within a few weeks, the Emir had assembled an army made up of troops summoned across the peninsula and was marching towards Seville. By the middle of November, the Vikings had been decisively defeated. Many were killed, most returned to their ships and fled, while some apparently stayed and settled in the area, eventually converting to Islam and becoming cheese traders. There's a part of me that really hopes the last part is true. More than anything, the Viking raid on Seville demonstrated how effective the Umayyad state was. It's vital to stress that the Umayyad response really was impressive, particularly when we compare their response to the often poor response of the Carolingians in France or the Anglo-Saxons in England. As a consequence of this attack, Seville had walls built around it to save it from a similar fate in the future. Thank you for tuning in, I hope you enjoyed that. I love making videos about really funky topics, I mean, the Vikings fighting Muslims in Spain is a really strange and exciting topic, I must admit. Make sure to check out the other videos in the collaboration for Vikings Month. They're made by an impressive bunch of YouTubers like History Time, History with Hilbert, The History of Vikings, and Voices from the Past. And lastly, I want to thank my Patreons who continue to support the channel financially. I appreciate your help. Until next time, peace.